All right, hi, thanks for watching. So continuing the Whitney Houston discography on Patreon and continuing that journey into R&B songs I've never heard, this is Whitney Houston, Deborah Cox, same script, different cast. So this is one that got requested a lot back when I did like Deborah Cox, Nobody's Supposed to Be Here, like about a year ago. I might put this on YouTube actually, and then after that I'm going to react to I Have Nothing and I Will Always Love You from 2001. I think it's like the BET Awards or something to do with BET. It's that feeling when you know you're listening to a perfect song. This is obviously perfect. Wow. Bring it. Okay.
What you're saying could be true, but
back to Whitney. Yes, that's great. We're still going. Okay, okay. Fucking hell. How many? What a song. Well, that was stunning. I mean, that's a word I use quite a lot on the channel probably, but genuinely, like, that's one of the best songs I've ever reacted to on the channel. It's probably the best duet I've ever heard. I'm not like a big duet fan, they make me cringe a bit sometimes, but that was just absolutely, like, the duet was built into the story of the song. It's the first time in a song I've heard someone put their fingers in the ears and go la 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 la. That was an amazing choice. And then just when you get used to, like, wow, this is a brilliantly written song with, like, so much truth, great characters, great lines. And then at the end, you get, like, what, three key changes, and it just absolutely just takes off and gets more intense, more dramatic, more sad, more tragic. I mean, I was smiling throughout the whole thing because it's so great, but the actual story is full of sadness, betrayal, denial, letting people make their own mistakes. Just so artfully and skillfully written. That was so great. Let's get back and have a look again at some of those lyrics. First of all, real names at the start is an amazing choice. And then this idea that it's a scene, that it's a movie, that it's not even, it's like a construct. So clever. And it's one of those songs where the lyrics are so great because that metaphor, like, she's the star, the leading ladies, all it just all ties in. Like, if you had to write this kind of song, you couldn't do it better than this. Lights, camera. And then this verse starts with, like, Deborah saying, well, it could be true, but how can you give me advice? And Whitney says, I'm not hating. This is so amazing. Uncover your ears, girl. I mean, have you ever heard a song like this before? I never have. It's just incredible. Maybe my reasons are wrong, but I know. Love Deborah Cox's voice on this. I've only heard her on that other one song. Obviously, I recognise Whitney's voice a lot more and more familiar with that. But I like what Deborah brings to it. It's very subtle. And then this bit, fighting back, it's your fault. That's the problem, I love him too much. And when you love him, he becomes unattracted to you. And that is the truth about so many relationships. I'll leave it at that, but yeah. He hurts you. He'll leave you. And every key change feels like a different part of the story, like, oh, it's happening again. It's happening again. I'm going to change my mind. I'm going to double down on this guy. It's like every key change, she's getting more and more sure of what she's going to do. Yeah, such a brilliant song. There's so many great lines going back through that again. That thing about how if you love someone too much, they become unattracted to you. That's true. You know, that is a true one, I think. I can't say enough good things about it. The songwriting as well, I don't know who did that and I'll find out later, but the melody was great. The progression of it, the way it kind of built in intensity, the way the story carried on. And Whitney can still bring it too, not just in terms of her voice and the notes that she can hit, but like the attitude, the kind of wisdom. She just carries that all with her and it's just there in every word that she says. Deborah Cox was great as well. That is two classics of her by her now. So let me know if there's any more. I'd like to hear more by her. God damn, what a masterpiece that was. Right, I'm going to get into some more Whitney now. This is 2001. This is the BET performance. It's I Have Nothing and I Will Always Love You. Oh, amazing. I've not seen Kirk in a video for a long time. Nah, what you getting me as well, Whitney? Wow. And I hope, oh, man. Treat you. Yeah, that got me.